You're listening to PetLifeRadio.com.
I am Seth Peterson.
I am Dippy Hedren.
I'm Rhonda Schwartz.
I'm Doris Roberts.
This is Jesslyn Gilson.
Hello, I'm Victor Webb.
Hi, this is Charlotte Ross.
Hi, this is Ed Begley Jr.
What's up, you guys? This is AJ from the Backstreet Boys.
Hi, this is Shannon Elizabeth, and you're listening to Talkin Pets.
Talkin Pets.
Talkin Pets. And you're listening to Talkin Pets.
Talkin Pets.
Talkin Pets.
With Jon Patch.
Jon Patch.
You're listening to Talkin Pets with Jon Patch.
Hello, America, and welcome to Talkin' Pets with your host, Jon Patch. Join Jon and his expert guests with all of your pet questions, concerns, comments, and stories. Now it's time for Talkin' Pets with your host, Jon Patch.
And welcome to Talkin' Pets, heard coast to coast on your favorite radio station. This is Talkin' Pets, and I'm Jon Patch. Joining us is animal expert
Barry Siebold,
here to answer your medical questions and your behavior questions about your pets at 866-606-8255. That's 866-606-TALK. We want to speak to you. Pick up the phone and give us a call. The show is produced by our executive producer, Mr. Bob Page.
Hello, sir. Good afternoon.
What's up, Bobby?
2013.
Yep. Happy New Year. Also, with the help of Mr. Zach Budin, when you call in the Business Talk Radio Network, you will actually speak with Mr. Zach, and he will put you on the line with us at 866-606-8255. 866-606-TALK. We have a special guest joining us in this hour. Her name is Gail Thackray. We're going to be talking about her book, How to Talk to Your Pets, Animal Communication for Dogs, Cats, and Other Critters. We're going to be giving away a couple of her books as well, so if you have a question, give us a call. Once again, the number is 866-606-8255. You're listening to Talkin' Pets. I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Barry Siebold.
866-606-8255. This is Talkin' Pets.
If we could talk to the animals, just imagine it, chatting with a chimp and chimpanzee. Imagine talking to a tiger, chatting with a cheetah. What a neat achievement it would be. If we could talk to the animals, learn their languages, maybe take an animal degree. We'd study elephant and eagle, buffalo and beagle, alligator, guinea pig and flea. We could converse in polar bear and python, and we could curse in fluent kangaroo. If people ask us, can you speak rhinoceros? We'd say, of corceros, can you? If we conferred with our furry friends, man to animal, think of all the things we could discuss. If we could walk with the animals, talk with the animals, grunt and squeak and squawk with the animals, and they could talk to us.
Dedicated to all animals everywhere, if we could only return the love and respect they selfishly give us, the world would be a much better place. A portion of the profits from this book will go to help animals in need. How to Talk to Your Pets, Animal Communication for Dogs, Cats, and Other Critters by Gail Thackray. We want to welcome her onto the program right now. Hey, Gail, how you doing? Welcome to Talkin' Pets.
Hi, Jon. Thank you so much for having me.
Well, it's nice to have you on with us. I want to introduce you to Mr. Barry Siebold.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
I'm doing wonderful. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you.
You know, how long did it take you, actually, Gail, to put this book together?
Oh, you know what? I think I had a lot of help from the animals in spirit up there because it was really pretty quick. I was teaching people this and doing the workshops already, and then when I decided to write the book, I think it just all kind of came together.
Now, I want to get into, like, if people want to call you and ask a question about their pets, can you actually talk about the past, the present, the future?
Yeah, I mean, animals can talk to you about things that are going on in their life, but they somehow, they're able to kind of connect into this other world and more easily connect to the spirit world than we can. And we can actually talk to pets that are in spirit. We can talk to pets that are here. Pets know our future. They know what's going on with our life. It's amazing the things that they know.
On the people side of things, do you think that actually some people are born to communicate with animals versus some that just have, like, no clue and never will?
You know, I used to think that to be any kind of psychic or animal communicator, you had to be born that way, and you were also born, like, a little weird. But I didn't start doing this until I was 40. I had no idea I could do this. I mean, I loved animals, but I had a kind of a, people have midlife crisis. I had a, all of a sudden woke up and became psychic. And actually, first of all, I could talk to people, to spirits on the other side. And it wasn't until a few months later, I went to, I was at just this little shop, and this lady was giving a talk about animal communication, and I stayed and I listened, and people had pictures of their pets, and I took a picture of one person's cat, and I looked at the cat, and all of a sudden I felt like I was inside the body of the cat, and I could see in front of me these big pink slippers with a little
ball. Well, now you know now you know how a mouse feels, Gail.
And I said to the woman, "Do you have a pair of pink slippers?" And she looks a bit really weird. And she goes, "Yeah." And I said, "You know, I'm looking like I'm the cat, and I'm seeing these slippers going around and around and around, and they're driving me crazy. You must sit on your exercise bike while the cat watches you." She goes, "Oh, my gosh, I do." And I thought, this is really weird. How am I doing this? And I thought I was just making it up. But I clearly wasn't. And I think that we all can do this, and we just don't realize we're doing it. So it's almost like we have this inherent ability. We just kind of block it off. And a lot of time we just think we're making it up. So we hear our pets talking to us. We often, I mean, John, have you ever heard any of your animals that just kind of know when there's something wrong or when they want to go out or when they want something?
Well, I guess I've been born on that, what you said earlier, that kind of odd, weird thing, because I freaked out many of my friends, actually, because I mean, like yourself, maybe, or whatever, but I, for some reason, I get these visions, I see things, I'm not kidding, they pop in my head. I've actually described people's homes that I've never been at, where their dog was at, what was going on, what they were wearing, and I'm talking to them on the phone. I mean, weird things like that, I get these visions and I see. So I totally understand where you're coming from, and a lot of people have told me that, you know, I just need to tool what I have because, you know, you are born with it. Certain people are.
Yeah, but some people think, oh, well, I can't do it, you know. They could do it because they're special, and they have some special talent, but I can't do it. And I find when I do workshops, everybody comes out being able to do it.
Well, I think it's actually, I find when most of the time I see something or something appears to me or I'm able to know something, and you listen to your first instinct, basically, and then it's during times where you kind of let yourself go, where you're most relaxed. And also, it seems like if you're most depressed, a lot of things enter into you, at least for me.
Well, you know, our animals get very concerned when we're depressed, and that's when they're more likely to say, "Hey, Mom, hey, Dad," and to try to get a message across. And sometimes they'll come through in dreams. So I don't know if any of your listeners have ever had a strong dream about maybe an animal that passed over or an animal that they have. Sometimes we're just not listening. We're too blocked off, and they're trying to talk to us, and so they try to find that moment where we're a little bit quiet.
Would you ever think that actually what human beings are capable of that we're not aware?
Oh, I absolutely, totally believe there's a whole other half, and we just haven't woken up. And animals can do that very easily. They talk telepathically all the time, and they listen to us all the time. They read our thoughts, and they understand what's going on in life, and they can somehow connect into this knowledge. We could do it, but we have a harder time doing it because we've conditioned ourselves not to think that we can do it anymore.
You know, Gail, there is something that you just said a little while ago, and I'm looking here at your book that I just cannot believe. 40? Really? I'm looking at your pictures, and you said that, and I went, "No way! She is not 40."
Oh my gosh, you're so sweet. Actually, I just had my 48th birthday, so it's been a few years I've been doing this.
And you look like this?
I want whatever it is that you are taking.
Is it that California sun that you enjoy, or what?
You know, I also think when you open up spiritually, a lot better health comes to you. You're more vibrant, and it kind of shows from the inside out as well.
Well, there's a lot of vibrancy going on in you here.
Thank you.
A very attractive woman, no doubt about that. Well, if anybody's got a question across America and you want to ask Gail a question about your pets, give us a call at 866-606-TALK. That's 866-606-8255. We're open to that. How to Talk to Your Pets, Animal Communication for Dogs, Cats, and Other Critters by Gail Thackray. The publisher, Gail, what's the publisher on the book?
Publisher's Indian Springs.
It's
a small publishing company that does only spiritual books.
But
it is available on Amazon.
And you can find it. Is it available in bookstores as well?
A few specialty bookshops, but mostly on Amazon. And then, of course, I travel around and do a lot of these different expos. And so, you know, I do workshops and people come see me. So they can come and see me and get a book.
And you have a website as well, Gail?
Yeah, my website is just my name. It's GailThackray.com.
And that's thackray.com.
Yeah, Gail, G-A-I-L, Thackray, thackray.com.
Don't go away. We'll be right back with Gail. If you've got a question about your pets and how to talk to them, give us a call at 866-606-8255. The first call that comes in to Zach Buten, our producer there at the network, we're going to send you out an autographed copy of How to Talk to Your Pets. Call right now, and the book is yours, 866-606-8255. I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Barry Siebold.
Talking Pets.
We'll be right back, right after these messages. Stay tuned.
Petco.
Where the pets go.
Petco.
Where the pets go.
Pet Life Radio has tail wagging, fur flying, fabulous deals for our listeners from Petco. Get $6 off your order of $60 or more and up to 40% off the entire Petco site.
That's right.
But that's not all.
Because you're a Pet Life Radio listener, you'll also get free shipping on your order of $49 or more. $6 off, up to 40% off,
and free shipping
from Pet Life Radio and Petco. To get these awesome deals, go to PetcoDeals.com. That's PetcoDeals.com.
Petco,
where the pets go.
X-Power is a global brand that offers a complete line of stand dryers, cage dryers, and multiple blasters that cater to both home and professional groomers. Designed to be quiet, lightweight, and powerful, X-Power pet dryers will save you time, energy, and money. The X-Power B2 Pro at-home dryer is the perfect gift for family and friends. Please check out our specials at ViperPet.com and Amazon.com. For more information, visit xpower.ws or call 855-855-8868.
Let's Talk Pets on PetLifeRadio.com.
You're listening to Talkin' Pets. I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Barry Siebold.
That's one of the new singles by Bruno Mars. Unorthodox Jukebox is the name of the CD. If you want to check it out, it just came out. Great song. Once again, you are listening to Talkin' Pets. We're speaking with Gail Thackray. She is the author of How to Talk to Your Pets, Animal Communication for Dogs, Cats, and Other Critters. Of course, if you want to get the book, you can find it on Amazon. It's published by Indian Springs Publishing, so check it out. Or else you might possibly win one here on the show during the conversation with Gail, just as Bob did in Duluth, Minnesota. So Bob in Duluth, enjoy the book. We'll be shipping that out to you. And Gail Thackray, you're going to autograph that for him too, right?
Absolutely, yes.
Sounds good. Bob, you'll be getting that out to you from Gail, and she'll autograph it for you in Duluth. And congratulations on winning that book,
Bob.
How to Talk to Your Pets.
Do you have a special animal I can autograph it to as well?
Okay, great. Yeah, I mean, if you've got a pet that you wanted addressed to or whatever, you know, autographed to, just let us know on that as well. And Bob, if you want to call back, it's 866-606-8255. Let Zach know your pet's name, and we'll make sure that Gail does that as well. But Gail, this is always a fascinating subject for me. And one of the things that you are, you know, basically we were on rebroadcast the best of for the last 2 weeks because of the holiday and all, and we're live now. But the thing is that you coming on first in the new year, I thought it was really important, especially since I finally got out to see the world, you might say, because I'm always trapped in my office when I'm working. So other than the phone and the computer, I don't really get to communicate with people that often.
We don't let them out very often.
No, not much at all. But the thing is like you go out to dinner or you go out and meet friends. Most of the time people are spent sitting there talking on their cell phones or they're on their iPads. They're not really communicating with each other. So communication in the human society, you know, has kind of gone to the wayside, other than looking at a picture of someone and saying, oh, you're cute, so I'll talk to you. But you don't even know if that's the person. Whereas I thought communication was a big thing, because more and more you're finding that people, divorces like 65-70%, people are just kind of falling apart. So you're finding them living their lives a little bit more with their pets and trying to communicate with them and trying to get them associated to their households and so on and so forth. And, you know, you've got cats, you got dogs, you might have a turtle, you might have fish, and you want to know ways of communicating. So I thought it was really important to have you on, Gail, and talk about how to talk to your pets. And it's a great book that you brought out because it gives a lot of good advice.
And, you know, you can always ask your dog or your cat what they think about your new relationship.
I love that. Let me go whiz on his pants. My cat will do that. I hate to admit it, but my male cat, my female cat is a princess. This cat is, I swear, Gail, my female cat, I think, is a human trapped in a furry body.
She used to be an Egyptian cat, that's why.
Yeah, it's amazing with her. I've never met an animal like this in my life.
She used to be an Egyptian healing cat. That's why she just kind of puts up with the other cats like they're pets. But she feels like she's really special. And she says you don't give her enough credit, because she often will give you ideas and inspiration, and you don't even realize it's from her.
Oh, it's amazing what she does. I mean, she blows me away, honestly, the way that she acts and the things that she does. And I mean, she's like a dog. She's like a human. I mean, when I was sick, I had open-heart surgery one time, and then she was by my side the whole time, never left it. She sits at the corner of my bed just staring at the doorway, which I think is a protection mode. But the male cat, on the other hand, if he doesn't like who you are, don't leave your jacket laying on the floor. That's all I'm going to say, because he will take it upon himself to say, get out. So I'm going to wee-wee on it.
Yeah, but he loves you very much, and he's very protective towards you. So he often does that if he doesn't really like the people that come around.
Some people he doesn't do that to.
Like when you had the open heart surgery, you know, they feel our energy, and they actually will take off negative energy from us. That's why a lot of sometimes ailments that our animals have actually show up on the animal, it shows up, but it's a person that really has that issue. For instance, you know, if somebody says, oh, my dog has a problem with its right paw, then I'll say, well, what's the owner got going on with their foot? And sometimes you'll find that it's exactly the same thing. And it's because they kind of take out energy and mimic, and they try to show us what it is. Hey, go take care of that foot.
What do you think in terms of, like, bringing an animal into your life? It really does change kind of who you are.
I think they choose us. I think they come to us. It's not the other way around. Even if, you know, even if we've gone looking for an animal, it's them that know they're coming to us, and they're coming to us for a purpose, and they are our partners in life, and they might be coming as a healing animal, or they might be coming to help us through something, but often they're coming for us. They're just such unconditional love. And sometimes we'll lose an animal, and then later another one will come along, will just show up, and it'll turn out to be the same one, like it's been reincarnated and come back. I don't know if a lot of your listeners have experienced that, where they've had a dog and then that dog passed away, and then later another one just showed up.
Actually, throughout the show, we've talked with a couple other people that have said the same thing, that usually if an animal passes on you, you're going to be distraught, of course. I mean, it's an extension of the family that has just left. But all of a sudden, when another animal appears, whether it be a cat or a dog or something, there's a reason for that.
Yeah, sometimes they'll bring another one in right away. Sometimes they come in actually before they pass. Like they'll look for somebody else. They'll say, okay, I'm going to hang on a little bit longer until I can find a new cat for mom. And you'll find a new little kitten will just show up right before the older one passes. Or sometimes it's them that reincarnate, and they'll come back. They'll find a way to find you.
Well, I knew when I adopted my two cats, but especially Rainy, which is the female that I was talking about, she picked me. I mean, there was no doubt about it. That paw was going out of that cage at the shelter, and she was just like, I'm going home with you. Granted, they were all sick when I adopted them, so I wasn't able to bring them home for a couple of weeks, but when she came home, it was the best thing that ever happened.
Yeah, and you probably had her many times before. And I think that's a nice thing about learning animal communication is, yeah, it's always sad when you lose an animal. It's really devastating, but it makes you feel a little bit better to know that they are around, that you can still talk to them, and that they often will come back.
Did you ever see that movie yet that's out in the theaters? I think it's still out. It's one of my favorite of the year last year, and it didn't do a lot of money, surprisingly, but it's called Cloud Atlas with Tom Hanks and Halle Berry.
No, I didn't see that.
Great movie. It actually deals with lives and the people that you meet, that you knew them in your past in one capacity, and then you know them, of course, in your present life, and you will again know them in your future. And it deals with a lot of issues, from religion to suicide, and you know, a lot of people think that if you commit suicide, you'll be banished from heaven. And it deals with a lot of subjects, and I thought it was really interesting. And it also gets on the animal subject as well. I think it's a great movie. It's just too bad it didn't do better, but I highly recommend it. But we're going to take a little break. Gail, don't go away. We're going to talk a little bit more with how to talk to your pets, animal communication for dogs, cats, and other critters with Gail Thackray. We're going to send out another autographed copy of the book, and if you want it autographed to you and your pet or just to your pet, make sure you let Zach Buden, our producer, know. But the number is 866-606-TALK. Call right now. The number two call, the second call to come in, will get a copy of the book, How to Talk to Your Pets. 866-606-8255. I'm John Patch.
I'm Barry Siebel.
866-606-8255, and we're open to your calls as well. This is Talkin' Pets.
Talkin' Pets. We'll be right back after a short pause. Well, four to be exact.
Yeah! Introducing the new Brett Michaels Pets Rock Collection, exclusively at PetSmart. I created it for the pets that rock your world.
Shop the Brett Michaels Pets Rock Collection and celebrate PetSmart's 25th anniversary with up to 25% off thousands of items on the PetSmart site. Plus free shipping on orders of $49 or more. Go to PetSmartDeal.com. That's PetSmartDeal.com. PetSmartDeal.com.
Dyson.
The new Dyson Animal Vacs are powerful bagless upright vacuums for homes with pets. Air muscle and radial root cyclone technology generates the strongest suction power to powerfully remove dust, dirt, and pet hair from the home or car. To order your Dyson Animal Vac, go to DysonDeals.com. DysonDeals.com to order your Dyson Animal Vac today.
Dyson, music to your ears.
Welcome to Sassy Seniors, a show about our fabulous older dogs and cats. I'm your host, Kelly Jackson. You know, I wanted to create a show to really showcase our senior pets. And, you know, as a human population ages and lives longer, of course, so are our wonderful pets. But many of us with aging pets, it's so interesting. We have a tough time realizing or really admitting that they are seniors. So, in a way, I kind of like to think of our senior pets as wise puppies. What do you think about that? Be sure to join us for another edition of Sassy Seniors. And remember, celebrate your senior pets.
Every week on demand, only on PetLifeRadio.com.
Let's talk pets.
Let's talk pets.
On Pet Life Radio.
Pet Life Radio.
PetLifeRadio.com.
With this hour's Talking Pets news from the USA Today, live from the ranch, here's your host, Jon Patch.
From Reno, Nevada, the Nevada Humane Society says it's exceeded its goal to find homes for 1,200 pets in its Home for the Holidays pet adoption drive. The campaign began on November 15th and ended on Tuesday. Organizers say they topped their expectations by 25 animals finding homes for 1,225. Barry Siebold?
In Atlanta, Georgia, the state is purchasing land along State Route 96 to build 6 bear tunnels in a project that will allow black bears to avoid the often deadly traffic. The passages will be placed in spots where bears typically attempt to cross, which often include places where streams and wet areas meet the highway.
You know, I like those ideas, and I've heard about those tunnels for other animals like deer and stuff like that. But, you know, it opens up a whole thing there, because it's like, how do the bears know that this is what I've got to do? I've got to go through this tunnel.
I think it's kind of a learned behavior thing.
But not only that, though. I mean, what happens if there's cougars in the area or something like that? If I'm a cougar...
Then they'll go through it.
I'm going to go through and wait on the other side to see all the other animals come through, and I'll pick up my dinner.
Well, hey, there you go.
In fast Stuttgart, food. Arkansas, cold and snow since Christmas has helped Arkansas duck habitat only a little bit. Snow melt has increased water levels slightly, making the state more attractive to ducks, but much of the state remains drier than in recent seasons.
In Harlan, Kentucky, Sequoia Energy, which wanted to move 80 wild horses off a former surface mine site, has agreed to leave the herd alone. Sequoia is performing a 95-acre reclamation project in Harlan County, according to state records.
In Albuquerque, New Mexico, the last capybara in the Albuquerque Biopark Zoo has died. Zoo officials say an 11-year-old female capybara named Ginger was euthanized Thursday because of age-related spinal issues and impaired mobility. Capybaras are the world's largest rodent and can weigh up to 130 pounds.
In Deadwood, South Dakota, Neiman Timber donated $50,000 to the Spearfish Canyon Mountain Pine Beetle Project in its ongoing effort to save trees from the devastating insects.
Those beetles can be nasty, can't they?
They apparently eat a lot of trees.
You know, it's weird because it's been so much warmer out there that they're saying a lot of the insects and beetles and stuff like that are not dying like they should. So they're actually just getting to be more and more, so that's causing the devastation. It's crazy. Global warming.
Zombies.
866-606-TALK. You know they're out there. 866-606-8255. Once again, I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Barry Siebel.
Pick up the phone, give us a call. We're speaking with Gail Thackray. She's the author of How to Talk to Your Pets. Once again, the number is 866-606-TALK.
We don't ever want to bite our friends. Don't bite your friends. Don't bite your friends. We don't bite our friends.
Nuh-uh.
We don't pull their hair.
Uh-uh.
Friends are our friends.
Uh-huh.
So we treat them with care.
So don't bite your friends.
And once again, you're listening to Talkin' Pets. I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Barry Siebold.
I'm just going to say that the Bruno Mars thing was my pick, but this was Bobby's.
Yeah. I mean, I guess it's good advice. Don't bite your friends. Unless you're a zombie.
Yeah. I can see where he's going with it. I guess if you listen to it 1,000 times, it becomes catchy.
You know I'm going to be singing this for the rest of the night now.
I know,
telling
you.
Don't bite your friends.
It's like subliminal messaging. We're going to start doing a cheer now.
This is my ringtone.
Pick up the phone and give us a call at 866-606-TALK, 866-606-8255. Hey, congratulations to Helen out there in Mount Carmel, Tennessee. She's getting a copy of the book, How to Talk to Your Pets, Animal Communication for Dogs, Cats, and Other Critters by Gail Thackray. It's available on Amazon.com. You can also check it out through... it's put out by Indian Springs Publishing, and our best goes out to Helen. She's not feeling well out there in Tennessee, so Helen, we hope that you do better, and Happy New Year. We always send the best to Helen. She's one of our regulars, and according to what I hear from my producer at the network, Helen has pneumonia. So Helen, please get better soon.
And, rest
and,
up.
Yeah, I know that we're talking about you.
Does Ellen have a little a little cat? Because I think she's got some little healing energy at home with her.
I'm not sure, actually, what type of pet Helen has. I can't remember if she has a cat.
She's being watched over.
Well, I hope so. I mean, Helen's great. We love Helen. And,
can I just jump in and say, Barry, I don't know exactly who you are, but you have a lot of critters around you. Just want to say thank you. So I don't know if you work with a rescue or something, because they're not really your animals, but you have a lot around you, particularly a little chihuahua who had a problem with his left eye, and they say that you actually can talk to them very well. You just have a hard time believing it because your family was very science background.
Well, you're blowing Barry's mind right now.
Do you want to tell me who Barry is?
Barry.
I actually do have a chihuahua, and about a month and a half ago, she had a corneal ulcer on her left eye.
Yeah, okay, so that's your little healing one, and she wants you to know that you can communicate and you are hearing messages. You have a harder time because your family was really science-orientated and told you, you know, that stuff didn't exist. But just get quiet and talk to her, and she will.
She does. She is pretty good at telling me when she wants her Scooby snack. I am good at that.
That's pretty amazing.
That is amazing. And also that Barry just started with the rescue group with his sister Brenda and all. And
well,
we
that's
had...
the... Yeah, well, the rescue... my sister and I are involved in a human remains detection and live find volunteer organization.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty amazing.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool, Gail. And what I want to do is put it out, put the number out if anybody else wants to call in as a question like that.
Okay, I'm freaked out right now.
Blew Barry away.
You know, I have a thing I'd like to offer to your listeners. I have, it's a triangle that I have at home that I got from this great healer in Brazil called John of God, and I'm actually bringing him to Toronto in March. And when I have clients that have a sick animal, I take their picture and I put it in my triangle. So if anybody wants to email me a name of an animal that needs a little bit of healing, or a person that needs a little bit of healing, go ahead and email me and I'll put it in my triangle for them.
Okay, great. And if somebody wants to email you, can you give us our email? Do you want to give that out over the air?
Yeah, sure. Okay. In fact, if they want to do that, just send it to mywish@gailthackray.com and write the name of the person and what kind of a wish you want, what kind of a healing. And this is my John of God triangle. I'm bringing John of God to Toronto in March. And the site is johnofgodlive.com if you want to find out a little bit more about that.
And again, your email is mywish.
Mywish.
At gailthackray.com.
Yes.
And it's G-A-I-L is Gail, and Thackray is T-H-A-C-K-R-A-Y.
Yes.
You know, talking more about when you want to communicate with your pets, I mean, are there, like, what would you say that are the top five questions? If I'm looking at my cat right now and I want to communicate with my cat, what would be the top five questions that I would ask that cat?
Well, I say you always start with chit-chat stuff. So don't jump in with, hey, why are you peeing in the why are you peeing on the rug, or why are you chewing up the couch? You want to get some chit-chat stuff going. It's actually easier to start with somebody else's animal than your own, because you often question yourself when it's your own. So you better to practice on somebody else's animal and have the owner there so the owner can go, oh, yeah, they do, they love that, they like that, and ask them, you know, what's your favorite treat? What kind of things do you like to do? And then just quieten your mind and just see what's the first thing that pops into your mind. And often you'll be really surprised and say, I just got that your cat likes cucumbers. And they'll go, oh, my gosh, my cat just ate cucumbers yesterday. So I think if you practice on another animal and you can kind of get that feedback first, because on your own animals, you kind of go, well, that's what I would think they would think, or that's what I think they would say.
So do you, like, when you're first starting, do you, like, sit down with them and actually talk like, you know, we would talk, like talk out loud, or is it just stuff you just think?
No,
or?
It's actually not the spoken word. You're not actually picking up, they're not picking up on your words. They're actually picking up on your thoughts. That's why when you're saying, oh, don't do that, that's naughty, but really you're thinking, oh, that's so cute. What they're picking up on is, oh, that's so cute, you should do that some more. They actually pick up on our thoughts. And it's almost like if I said to you, what did you do on Valentine's Day last year? You kind of go back in your mind and you think about it. And then a memory comes to you, hopefully. And you could explain that memory to me, but you can tell me I went to a restaurant and had this great dinner, but you can't actually send me the smell and the taste, right? But what happens with an animal, it's like they send you the whole thought package. They can actually send you it like it's a memory. So they send you the smell and the taste and everything. So when you ask them, what's your favorite treat? And I got this one time at a kind of very posh dinner party when the dog said, sweaty socks. And they actually send
Bobby
you.
Likes sweaty socks, too.
I do not like sweaty socks.
Sweaty socks. And they actually send you that packet of information. So you actually experience the whole thing. And then you find, like, wow, I was kind of enjoying those sweaty socks. So that's not really my thought. It must be somebody else's thought. So it's like they send you a packet of thought.
And then you look over and see Fido sitting there in the corner, drooling, right?
You know,
so
I think,
when you communicate with an animal, you just kind of get quiet. You have to take the time just to sit and get quiet.
It's almost like a meditation type thing?
Yeah, like meditation, but okay. You don't have to, like, you know, go nuts or anything. Just get in that kind of quiet, relaxed zone. And then the most important thing is to send love. You want to get in that space where you're just really appreciating them and sending them love. They don't have to be in front of you. They can be in another room. I tell people to start with photographs of people's friends' animals. And you just look at the photograph and you look at their eyes. And then you just imagine that you are sending love to them, and you get that connection going first. And then you ask permission. Can I have a chat with you? And then you ask them, through your mind, telepathically, what's your favorite treat? What's the favorite thing you like to do? And when the messages come back, it comes back really fast. So if you're sitting there going, oh, is it this? Is it that? And you're working too hard. It's literally the first thing that pops into your head. Like you were saying earlier, John, it's your first instinct.
Yeah, you know, it's funny because a lot of people, I think a lot of people feel that in general. I mean, they go, if they want to do something, the first instinct kicks in, and then they start overthinking it. And they're like, oh, well, what about this or what about that? Well, no, listen to the first instinct because that's usually right.
Yeah, exactly.
What about in the name? Like, a lot of what we're talking about is covered in how to talk to your pets, animal communication for dogs, cats, and other critters. But what about in the name that you give your pet?
Oh, the name that you call your pet. Well, that's very important. You don't want to call your pet something that you don't want it to turn out to be, you know, because they do kind of recognize what their name is. So, you know, you don't want an aggressive dog or a dog that barks all the time and you call it Barker.
I mean, right now, according to some surveys, the number one name right now this year, or actually last year, into this year, is for both dogs and cats, is Bella. And I think that has a lot to do with the Twilight movies that are out, because that's the name in the movies. That's just my own assumption. But that's the number one name.
That is so strange, because I just adopted two more pups. I have a whole bunch of adoptees, but I just adopted two more, and one of them I called Bella.
See?
And I thought Albert was going to be so popular.
Hey, don't go away, Gail. We got to take a little break. When we get back, we're going to continue on with Gail Thackray. We're talking about her book, of course, How to Talk to Your Pets, Animal Communication for Dogs, Cats, and Other Critters. We have one more book to give away. So the number three call that came into Zach Budin, our producer there at the network, give him a call at 866-606-8255. That's 866-606-TALK. 866-606-8255, and the book is yours. The number three call that comes in, and if you've got a question for Gail, we welcome them in as well. I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Barry Siebel.
You're listening to Talkin' Pets.
Talkin' Pets. We'll be right back after a short pause. Well, four to be exact. Yeah!
Every pet is unique. Maybe they're gray in the muzzle, yet young at heart. Maybe they're growing out of the puppy stage and into their paws and ears. Or maybe they're just trying to maintain a more girlish figure. At PetSmart, we have the right food for your pet at a great value for you. PetSmart. Be better together.
Go to PetSmartDeal.com and save up to 30% on pawsome gifts for the pets and pet people in your life. Toys, collars, leashes, PetSmart gift cards, treats, and more. Go to PetSmartDeal.com today. PetSmartDeal.com.
I'm not much of a reader, but I do wish I were more well-read.
There are so many great books coming out. I wish I could find a way to keep up.
Audible.com makes it easy to stay well informed and catch up on your reading simply by listening. Audiobooks from Audible turn downtime into uptime. You'll be more productive and become well-read.
Now I'm able to catch up on all the great books I've been wanting to read.
With Audible, I feel smarter.
Pet Life Radio listeners, try Audible.com now and get your first 30 days of Audible Listener Gold Membership Plan free. And get a free audiobook. Choose from over 100,000 titles. To get this great deal, go to audibledeals.com. That's audibledeals.com.
This year, Americans are expected to spend a jaw-dropping $36 billion on their pets. From lighted leashes to high-end spa products, the discriminating pet owner can find just about anything to pamper his or her pet. Hi, this is Michelle Fern. Join me every week for Best Bets for Pets, where we'll talk about the latest pet products and talk to the companies that make them. Best Bets for Pets, every week, only on PetLifeRadio.com.
Let's talk pets.
Let's talk pets.
On Pet Life Radio.
Pet Life Radio.
PetLifeRadio.com.
Listening to Talkin' Pets, I'm Jon Patch.
I'm Barry Siebold.
866-606-8255 is the number. 866-606-TALK. If you've got a question, we're speaking with How to Talk to Your Pets, Animal Communication for Dogs, Cats, and Other Critters by Gail Thackray. And if you've got a question, give us a call. 866-606-8255. Congratulations to Jared in Memphis, Tennessee. Jared, you're getting a copy of the book, How to Talk to Your Pets, and it'll be autographed to you or whatever name that you left with Zach Buden, our producer there at the network. 866-606-8255. You know, when we were going out to the break, Gail, we were talking about names and all and giving your pets names, mm-hmm. but Bobby has a pet named Albert, and do you see anything in particular about his dog? He's our executive producer here.
Well, Albert quite likes his name. I think it fits him.
That it does.
And is he kind of stocky?
He is not stocky.
I don't know. He feels like he's a tough guy. He maybe doesn't look like it is, but he feels like he is. And I think you had this one before as a bigger dog when you were younger. Did you have a bigger dog when you were younger that passed away?
I had a border collie. It's not really a big dog, maybe 30 pounds, 35 pounds.
Border collies
bigger,
are
bigger
big.
Than Albert.
Albert feels like he thinks he's tougher than he really is.
Albert, personally, on the outside looking in, I would agree with that because Albert, to me, and I don't know Albert that well, only when you bring him around, but he always seems like he's a tough dog. You always say how sweet he is and this, but to me, I think because he's always jumping and, but there's, you know, I don't know.
Okay, Albert wants to know a little bit more the schedule. He's one of these dogs that likes to know when everything's going on. And now, who's his owner?
Bobby, our executive producer.
Bobby, you don't talk to him enough about when you come in and going. Your schedule seems to be kind of all over the place.
Well, that's true.
Yeah.
And if you just tell him, you know, hey, I'll be home at 5. And then if you're not home at 5, when you're on the freeway stuck in traffic, you just send him a little message saying, I'm going to be a little bit later than I said.
Okay. You can do that.
Because it's something he's doing that you don't like. He messes something up or he digs something that you don't like.
He's doing something I don't like?
Yeah. What is he doing that you don't like?
Actually, he's been a really good boy as of late. I mean, he's almost 9 years old, mm-hmm. and he was born blind.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and that's the other thing he was mentioning. He's looking at your eyes. So do you need to have your eyes checked, or what's going on with your eyes?
With me?
Yeah.
No, I'm good.
Okay, then there's something you're not looking at. Something you don't want to face. John, is that what he's like? When he doesn't want to deal with something, he just like pretends it's not there, doesn't want to look at it?
He does. He won't admit it, but he does. Bobby's very opinionated. If it doesn't go Bobby's way, it doesn't go.
Okay. So he's saying there's something that you're kind of refusing to look at. You need to check in.
Hey, before we run out of time, though, I want to, on moving from Bobby, Sherry in Columbia, South Carolina, wants to ask you, Gail, a question about her pet.
Okay.
Sherry in Columbia, how you doing?
I'm fine. How are y'all?
We're doing wonderful. Welcome to the show, Sherry.
Thank you. We lost our 15-year-old boykin, Shelly, back in September, and it was the connection we had with her is completely different than what we have with our 11-year-old male, Mac. And we have noticed since she passed away that his demeanor has changed some, and I don't know if it may be because she was, even though he was the mouth the alpha male, she still rules the home. Is it normal for their demeanor to change like that? And is there any way that, or is it just in the dog themselves, although they think they're human, that, and we treat them like they're our children, that, that we can find a closer connection with him, or would that maybe just come in time?
Well, he's going through a little bit of grief and a little bit of adjustment. Mm-hmm. And she just wants to say, she's running around, jumping up and down happily now, which she used to do when she was young and hasn't been able to do for a long time. Her mm-hmm. back end got really, really bad, really slow. And I don't think you know, but she did have cancer in her bones. Do you know? Did you know that?
No, we knew she had health issues with her heart and her lungs, and she was clotting, and they couldn't ever get her stable enough.
Yeah.
To check any of that. But the odd thing is, about a week after she passed away, I had a dream two nights in a row that she was with my grandmother.
Yeah, see, and I got chills, because that's not really a dream. That's an actual connection. That's her coming and telling you. My very first communication was through a dream. Mm-hmm. And they do. They come to you, and when you feel them that strongly, that's mm-hmm. because they're really there, and she's going to stay around you. The male that you have, he's just taking a little bit of adjustment, because she had a lot of roles in the family that he's now got to take on more things.
Yeah, he's and he's become a lot more loving. He's not the alpha, you know, the real strong, you know, doesn't want, where he used to not let you hold him and rub him, he yearns for that now.
Well, she used to be your healing dog, so she was the one that would come around if you weren't feeling well, put mm-hmm. her head on your lap.
That's right.
She would come and put your head on your lap. And your grandma that passed?
She passed away in 1979.
You know she had cancer?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So she's showing me that on her, and it actually might not have been her that had it. She might be showing me on your grandma. So that's just a confirmation mm-hmm. that it is her. And there's some kind of treats. It's kind of like a little... It looks like a commercial treat that you get, because it's kind of a strip of something, but you didn't give it them very often. Do you know what that is?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. She's saying she's getting lots and lots of those up there.
Hey, Gail.
Oh, great. Can't let Mac know that.
Gail, Sherry, I've got to say goodbye. Spay and neuter your pet, self-control that pet population from ourselves. This is Jon Patch.
Dr. Ann Lamprew.
And Amanda Page.
Thanks for joining us in this hour of Talkin' Pets.
Let's talk pets every week on demand. Only on PetLifeRadio.com.